First, we have Matt Hart on your far left there. Matt earned his Bachelor of Science in Interior Design from the Art Institute International in Minneapolis. Matt has worked in the Interior Architecture and Design Practice Group at HGA for the last 5 years. His works included a wide range of project types, such as corporate offices, schools, college campuses. Because Matt has developed this diverse skill set combined with strong technical aptitude, we like to have Matt involved in all phases of our projects, from early sketching ideas to construction administration. And Matt is—he's one of the hardest people, hardest working people I know at HGA, and I think I finally figured out why. Because you see, at HGA, our interiors group is made up of about 90% women, and they're all very attractive and fashionably dressed. And so Matt likes to show up. He likes to be the first person to show up in the morning and the last person to leave. So let's welcome Matt Hart.
Thanks, John. So I was actually a little surprised that I got asked to participate in this presentation. I was actually walking through the Denver airport very sick when I got a text from one of the designers in our department who suggested that I be one of the presenters. My initial response was, "Are you joking?" And after talking to her a little bit, she made me actually realize that sketching has become a very important part of my career, and I don't even think that I had realized it until we started talking about it. I have kind of a different background. When I was younger, I was not an artist at all. I dreaded art class, could not draw, could not sketch. And actually, when I started going to college, I was going to school for cultural anthropology, partially because I didn't think this was something that I could do. So I went for a couple of years, decided it wasn't a good fit, took time off, and I still came back to design. So when I came back, still couldn't really draw, but some of the technical drafting, technical perspectives taught me that there was a way that I actually could communicate my ideas. But I still struggled with freehand sketching. And then as I started working, that fear kind of came back as I started working with really talented designers and architects who could sit down and produce a sketch in a matter of seconds that would take me days and days and days and still wouldn't be at the same level. So there's a period of time when, during my career, where I still was really hesitant to sketch. And it wasn't until I started doing construction meetings and going to construction sites and really talking to the subcontractors and trades who were building our ideas and working from our drawings and trying to work through issues with them that I realized that words weren't enough to communicate what we were trying to communicate. And so I would start sketching on walls knowing that they'd get painted over, or sketching on my meeting minutes knowing that no one would ever really see them. But I realized that it became a really effective way to help them understand the relationships that we were trying to establish. So after I started to get some confidence in doing that, I started really using it as a tool for myself. And in a lot of ways, they're extremely, extremely basic sketches, but it's a way that I was able to communicate with myself. And as I was starting to work through an idea or a concept or a layout, just the ability to really quickly take a pen and start drawing on paper allowed me to have a conversation with myself or with the team. And it's a way that you can talk or communicate that you can't do with words, because we're talking about three-dimensional space. We're talking about objects, we're talking about volumes, and words aren't always enough. And as I did this more and more, I would start to do it in front of clients. And even, something as crude as that, when you're sitting in front of a client, when I did that sketch, the client was amazed. She was like, "Oh, yeah, now I understand what you're talking about. This is what we're going to do in this corner of this room." And it's not a great sketch, admittedly. Most of what I do tends to be kind of throwaway sketches. They're part of the process. They're not these precious artifacts. And actually, when I was trying to pull things together for this presentation, I struggled a little bit. I had to go through old project meeting notes and kind of ask some people across our office if they still had anything that they were holding on to. And kind of pulling that together started to make me realize that there are very different aspects of projects that I use this as a way to communicate with project teams, contractors, or even clients. It can be as basic as trying to figure out the relationship of objects in space. It generally, when I sketch, it tends to be a more finite idea that I'm trying to resolve. But it's a much more effective way in my mind than jumping straight into a computer. When you jump straight to the computer, you're really dealing with some sort of fixed elements, and especially with the transition to Revit, where you're building with components and different kind of pre-built families. And this gives you the freedom to step back from those components and pre-established notions and really think about what you're trying to get across, how you want items to come together, how the detail should resolve itself. And it's also, as a function of the program, we make design decisions extremely early in the process, and you have these elements that are coming together, and when you blow up a plan detail or drop an elevation, Revit's reporting information back to you. So there are early decisions that you're seeing that you may not have that notion of how those pieces should be coming together. And so you almost need to strip away some of the information that the program's giving you. And sketching, in my mind, is a way to reverse that process. And you can start layering in the information the way that you see it rather than trying to remove the information from what the program is giving you. This is another, well, this particular example is just trying to resolve the front elevation of a conference room. It was me and one of the architects in our office. We were talking through it, and we didn't really have any pen or paper. We were just talking, and after about 30 seconds, I realized it was going nowhere. And I grabbed this, started sketching really quickly, and after about 2 minutes, we were able to kind of develop an understanding of what we wanted to present to the client. And if we had taken the time to just talk through it, I don't know that we would have really been able to have that conversation or resolution. And then another really important piece in my mind is tying back to that notion of details. So these details are something that I was actually working with some of our younger staff. And rather than pulling out a set of drawings or trying to go to a detail that we've used on a number of projects, actually taking the time to sit and talk through how the detail should not only look, but the parts and pieces that go into it, tends to be a much better way to learn the process and thought process behind how these parts and pieces want to come together. And admittedly, they're incomplete details at this point, but that's partially because they're just supporting the conversation. So as you're drawing each of the pieces, you can start to think through the sequence of how they would go together on site. You can think about how it's being communicated within our drawing sets and how it's interpreted on site. And then the last piece that I kind of wanted to talk through, and this was a project that I was actually lucky enough to work on John with. This was a corporate office downtown Minneapolis, and I stumbled across this drawing that was a millwork section, and as I was thinking through some of the other details throughout the space, just really crudely sketching some of the relationships, how in my mind the parts and pieces would come together, and even that really preliminary notion of how these pieces should come together allowed me to understand what those details should look like as we draw them. And I think hopefully one of the ideas you can take away from this is that something as crude as that can help the thought process to arrive at some of the details that you see in this shot, where it doesn't have to be a beautiful detail to start out with. I think the notion of actually eliminating your inhibitions and putting pen to paper to get ideas across starts to develop a thought process where you can free yourself from kind of the preconceived notions of what details have already been drawn, what's the program giving us, and what's, in some ways, what might be the easy way out. That's what I have.